couple of years ago, we agreed to sign up to a climate change emergency. But unlike many other councils, we developed a strategy immediately on the back of that. So what that meant was we were able to assess the levels of carbon produced in the district, but also by ourselves as a council. And we committed to feedback on that, so we'd measure each year how we're doing, and we put in place a series of other targets. So some of the actions we've undertaken already, we've installed electric vehicle charging points across the district. We're beginning to move our fleet, that we use for grounds maintenance and others, to become electric vehicles. And as the technology improves, we'll do the larger vehicles as well. We're looking at the energy efficiency of all of our properties. Leisure centres, for example, they're crucial for improving our health and our lifestyles, but by virtue of having swimming pools and others, they are energy intensive. So we're looking to have solar panels on those, revise and improve the boilers as we can going forward, but also premises like the Palisade, the National Civil War Centre, our own offices. We will look to green up and generate the electricity wherever we can. In addition, we're putting in place new planning policies for new homes and properties that they must have provision for cycling, looking to reduce parking spaces, but also high levels of energy efficiency so that they too contribute going forward. So looking at what the district itself needs to do to meet our target of being carbon neutral by 2035, it's equivalent, and I'll try to remember this, to 12.99 million miles in a family diesel vehicle. It's a lot of carbon to reduce, but as a district council, our contribution to the district, we are simply 1% of the carbon produced in Newark and Sherwood, and if we add in our own housing stock, 2%. So we're working on those properties as well to do our bit, but it's vital we work with our communities to do more. So, our tree planting scheme, we committed to plant 10,000 trees by just 2023, and already we've planted near 6,000, 5,997 to be precise. And we've done that working with parishes, giving trees to people to plant in their own gardens, but also some larger schemes, and with your help, recycling Christmas trees. So we're well underway on that. And do you know what? When we reach 10,000, we won't stop. I want to see more done on that under the National Tree Strategy, and also we ensure again that all new developments include trees and hedgerows, because this isn't just about absorbing carbon, it's about enhancing biodiversity and the nature in our district. So to that extent, all the different work we're doing, assessing the open space strategy to make sure we have not only the amount of open space we need as communities, but again, also for wildlife. So we're categorising green space, open space, play areas, playing pitches. And I know in some areas there is a deficiency and we will acquire more and improve those spaces going forward. So 2 years into delivering the strategy, 6,000 trees planted already, increasing the electric fleet, doing what we can on those properties, and vitally, at little commitment to the council tax. We set aside around about £800,000 for this, but every grant that is being made available, I'm after them. We will continue to do this. Like I say, when we hit those targets, we'll exceed them. But we are well on track to delivering what we promised to do for you. And I hope going forward now with that other 98% of carbon, we can do a great deal more working with you.